Scott here with DontForgetToPackTheKids.com and on Twitter at PackTheKids. Well, we brought the family out today to the Salina Turda salt mines here in western Transylvania in the city of Turda in Cluj County. We're about half an hour south of the capital of Transylvania at Cluj-Napoca. A little bit of traffic behind me, but it can't be avoided. You can see in the background, I hope, is the salt mine itself. It's a pretty big attraction here, and we thought it'd be really cool to bring the family out. It's about a 2.5 hour drive from where we've been living, so it's a bit of an investment in time to come out here. The salt mine is very cool. It's built in the mid-1800s, so it's pushing 200 years old now, and there's a pretty cool museum exhibit if you're into mining and want to learn more about salt extraction processes. That part, very cool, and you get to walk through the actual mine itself, so it's very neat. It's an experience you don't get too often. But the downsides are really that the things that you really want to go see, the things that they promote in the mine, are basically playground and carnival sideshow, kind of like cheap Ferris wheels and cheap merry-go-rounds and a little playground, and they really aim things at kids who are about 7 and younger, which we thought would be great. But we got here, and it turns out all that stuff is at the bottom of very deep mine shafts, at least 80 meters down. There's no working elevator, and it's 80 meters to get down to the first set of stuff, which is very little. And then if you want to see anything more, we're not even sure how to get farther than that. It's 15 flights of stairs, and they're rather precarious. Not a place where you could bring a seven-year-old or younger child to go see things. So it's kind of a weird mix of things only aimed at really small children and only adults able to access them. So we were unable to check out any of that stuff and found the entire experience incredibly disappointing with children. I wouldn't recommend bringing kids here at all. There is, and it's a little bit hard to see here in the background, but in front of the salt mine, there's actually a small like vendor area where maybe 20 or maybe 30 vendors have little stalls with some souvenirs, candy, corn on the cob. There's a couple of really small cafes with hamburgers, hot dogs, french fries, that kind of thing. A little bit of traditional food, either traditional Romanian, or there's even a little traditional German bakery thing going on, but it's all pretty basic and not things you would come here for, but it gives you a little bit to do outside of the mine itself. It sounds, when you look at the website or you're looking on TripAdvisor or something, it really comes across as a place that's going to be great for a family outing. Reality is, it's not, at least not from what we experienced. And we spent a lot of time down in the mine confused because they don't have any signage that tells you where to go and how to find the things that they're promoting. And a lot of the, they have these numbers that tell you where to go. A lot of them are just missing. So we spent a lot of time trying to investigate where things were. And it turns out that almost everything that would be of interest either to kids or to adults who are investigating the history of mining and really want, because there's an ancient Roman salt mine down there as well. All of that stuff is closed and locked away, and so you can't really get to anything. So the experience is actually incredibly shallow, and you could do the whole thing in maybe 15 or 20 minutes, and it's not going to be of interest to kids at all. The highlight of the trip was getting to see a 152-year-old pulley that still works. It's not being used, but officially it still works. That's it, looking at a big pulley in the ceiling. That's kind of what you come to see, other than the absolute cool fact that you're walking through an ancient salt mine. The walls are made of salt, the floor is made of salt, the ceiling's made of salt. You can lick it, don't do that, but you can lick it, and it's just salt. You can touch it and really see what a salt vein is like. That is incredibly interesting, but it only is interesting for a few minutes. And so unless you're in the area and very close, it's about 20 lei to get in, which is about $5 US, which is not bad at all. But it's a bit much considering how little there is. So that's our take on the Salina Turda salt mine here in Cluj County, Transylvania, Romania. Thanks for joining us, and we look forward to bringing you more of Europe and the world on Don't Forget to Pack the Kids.